Bitcoin is all the rage right now. The virtual currency has been on a wild ride as trading volume spiked. When we first told you about it a week ago, Bitcoin was trading about $134 on the Mt. Gox exchange. Earlier this week, it shot up to an all-time high of $266. Now, it's gone all the way down to $91, a lot of volatility. So, of course, now some are calling for regulation. But Bitcoin was created to be open source, decentralized. The government steps in to regulate it. Doesn't that defeat the purpose? Joining me now is Roger Ver, CEO of Bitcoin Store, an online electronics retailer that only accepts Bitcoin. That can't be easy. And Jim Angel, a Georgetown University professor of finance who does think that regulation is needed. Thanks to both of you for joining us. James, I'm going to start with you. What do you make of this madness?
Well, I think Bitcoin has turned into a massive multiplayer online game where speculators are trying to out-speculate each other. It's not what we're looking for in a monetary system.
Roger, what do you think about that? Is it just an online game? It does have a game-like feel to it.
Well, I'm sure there's lots of people that are speculating on Bitcoin, but if they are, it's their money to do it with, and it's none of the government's business what people do with their own money. And that's why Bitcoin was created, so that people have 100% complete control over their own money. And it's the first time in the entire history of the world in which something like that's existed. And it doesn't matter what country they're in or where they are in the world, they can send and receive money with anyone else anywhere in the world, and there's absolutely nothing anyone can do to stop it.
But Roger, you know, people who have it don't really have control over it because the value of it, I mean, look at the chart, is sinking and skyrocketing every second, so you don't have any control.
Well, that's if you look at it, yeah, it's down a little bit from a couple of days ago, but it's still up more than 500% since the beginning of this year, and it was up several 100% last year as well and the year before that. And, you know, Bitcoin's a voluntary thing. People can use it if they want to. If they don't want to, they don't have to. They can still use the dollar. And that's the beauty of it, is that nobody's forced to use it. It's just if people want to, they can use it. And millions of people around the world are choosing to use it because they do see that it's better than the other options that they have available to them.
James, what do you think about those points? They make a lot of sense.
Well, in the 19th century, we used to have a monetary system that was outside the control of governments. We called it the gold system. And we discovered it created a financial system that was so brittle, it broke with great recessions every 5 to 10 years. And we also discovered that the money supply didn't grow to fit the economy. So this notion that, ooh, it's outside the control of government, we've tried it, been there, done that. And as the old quote says, if you don't learn the lessons of history, you're doomed to repeat it.
But James, I mean, the point that Roger made that kind of applies to what you just said is that that's when systems were totally dependent on those currencies. This is a tiny fraction of the economy. There's a tiny fraction of people using it. I mean, it's getting a lot of attention because there are people making a ton of money in it right now, and there are people losing their shirts in it. So that's why it's getting so much attention. But, you know, you can go use dollars if you want to, and you know, it's not obligatory. So I don't know. Maybe it's not that big of a deal. James, what do you think?
Right. I agree with that in that it's voluntary. If other people want to go and speculate on some Japanese trading card exchange, hey, go for it. However, don't confuse it with a real monetary or payment system. It's a game.
Roger, you only take Bitcoins exclusively in your online site. How does that work exactly? I mean, do you hold them? Do you translate? Do you convert them back to dollars?
Yeah, I'm confident that Bitcoin is the most important invention in the entire history of the world since the internet. And because the supply of Bitcoins are limited, the price is going to go up. So every order we get on BitcoinStore.com, I just hold the Bitcoins. I don't convert them into dollars. I trust Bitcoins more than I trust dollars or euros or yen. And you can see around the world all the crazy things that governments are doing to debase their currencies. With Bitcoin, that can't happen. And it's protected by the laws of mathematics, not the laws of men. We don't know what the U.S. government's going to do with the dollar tomorrow or what the Europeans are going to do with the euro. And the Japanese are going crazy printing Japanese yen as well. With Bitcoin, I don't have to worry about any of that. I know exactly how the Bitcoin protocol is going to behave. And I don't have to trust any government politician somewhere else to with my money. I have complete control over what I do with my own Bitcoins.
It's a very adamant position, Roger.
Right.
James, wait, let me ask you before you go. Who would have jurisdiction over this? I mean, wait, really, because you have to think that as this phenomenon is going on, you're seeing more and more media about it, the price is all over the place, that someone in Washington is thinking, this is mine to regulate. Would it be, you know, the Treasury coming in? I think they put out a note saying that maybe they would oversee the exchanges. What do you think could really happen legally? What makes sense?
Well, the Federal Reserve has jurisdiction over payment processors. So To the extent that payment processors step into the picture, they could be regulated by the Fed. But the important thing is force and fraud. We want to make sure that we don't have criminals in the system here. And this notion that this computer algorithm is hacker-proof,
right,
or that it really is limited, when we don't even know who created this thing.
Yeah.
So really, it's too shadowy, too speculative. And you know, as long as people play games offshore, let them. But don't confuse it with a real monetary system, because it's not.
Gentlemen, thanks to both of you for coming on. Some great insight and a great debate. We appreciate both your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.